You and I don't live long beyond 100 years. But our rishis and munis and people, Hunsrus and others in Uzbekistan, they live 120 years. Why? We have too much oxygen here. There is very little oxygen there. Oxygen is one of the biggest problems for us, too much oxygen. In the olden days, when somebody got a heart attack when I was a student, and later on also, we used to immediately give oxygen. Now we know we have killed millions of people by giving oxygen when the man gets a heart attack. You need hypoxia at that time. Now I have developed something to produce hypoxia for all of you every day so that you will live long like Hunsrus. High altitude living is good. It encourages preconditioning in the various organs like the heart. When you give hypoxia, it is like pension. When you retire, you get less money, so you have to know how to live with less money. So you teach it earlier when you are when you are the professor of physiology and the head of the director of the Institute of Physiology and things like that. Then you know how to live with less money. After you retire, you are very happy. But when you are in the top, you enjoy it. And then suddenly you retire, you feel like a bit suicide. Stimulus erythropoietin. Now we can study the cells. Human body. ಅಣ್ಣ ಒಂದು ಲೋಟ ನೀರು ತರ್ತೀಯ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಒಂದು ಬಾಟ್ಲಿ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಹುಡುಗ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಲನಿ ಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಆರ್ ಎ ಕಾಲನಿ ಆಫ್ 100 trillion ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ದೇ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಈಚ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ Number of years, millions of years. Then they thought, for economic reasons, because Manmohan Singh must have taught them some economics. So they said, we'll come together. Why all you alone, So they came together. When they came together, we call it as a human body. Then when they came together, they said, why should everybody do everything every day? So they started saying, say a few cells, hey, you do the work of looking after all the nervous system, call him brain. You do the breathing business, call it lung. You do the pushing heart, blood business, call it as heart. You do the walking business, call it as a muscle. And you do the strength, call it as bone. And that's how we have become a body. Today you can study these cells, individual cells. Every cell emits a photon particle light, which till now could not be studied. But now there is a physicist called Fritz Albert Popp. And Fritz Albert Popp has devised a photon camera. Very, very interesting camera. See, this is how the picture comes. Now, if all the cells are in sync, if all the cells are happy with one another, they're dancing together, you are in healthy. When they're out of sync, you have disease kind, different kinds of illnesses in the body. When you treat it and they come back, you get a normal picture. And that's the photon camera. So, Fritz Albert Popp has defined health as a state of perfect subatomic communication of the cells. And disease as a breakdown of that. When you are ill, your cells are out of sync. Now I'll give you a secret of how to be healthy. These cells love one another. Did you know that? They love one another so much. They love other cells also because you are a part of me. Did you understand? Singh Saab is a part of me because he is a part of the universal consciousness called individual consciousness. I'm a part of the same universal consciousness. So if I hurt Singh Saab, I'm hurting myself. That is why when I want to say, I want to take this Singh Saab from his chair, I want to sit in that chair, then my cells get confused. What is this BMHD fool doing? He's hating his own body. So after some time, if I keep on doing that, my own cells hate my own cells, autoimmune disease. Horror, auto, toxicus, Paul Ehrlich said. See how interesting it is? And this is very interesting. Now we have changed the definition of health. And with this, we went to the IOM, Institute of Medicine. And the Institute of Medicine now has accepted the word WP, whole body, whole person healing, WPH, as the future of medicine, WPH. 20th February 2010. The meeting of the IOM in Washington, they accepted this and it's coming. So I have defined health as, health is enthusiasm to work and enthusiasm to be universally compassionate. Health is enthusiasm to work and enthusiasm to love, Richard Smith of BMJ. And need a new definition of health, said Fiona. And health is work and love, said Freud. Now, completely it's changed. Very easy to know whether you're healthy or not. I always tell people, if you're healthy, don't see a doctor. If you want honor, don't go to the police. If you want justice, don't go to the court. But if you're not well, go and see a doctor. Even if it is headache, see a doctor. Not necessarily that you should take his medicine, but see a doctor, find out what it is, and discuss with him. Be a partner in your treatment. And if somebody hits you, then go to the police and say, hit me, you know, just protect me. And if somebody has done injustice, you could go to the court. But going to a doctor when you're healthy is the most dangerous thing that you can do, is an article in the British Medical Journal. I have written it earlier, but British Medical Journal writes that. Read that. So I always tell people, don't go to see a doctor when you're well. Then they say, how do I know I'm well? Ayurveda says so beautifully. Samadhatuhu, samagnischa, samadoshaha, malakriha. Prasannatma indriya manaha swastha itya vidyate. You shit well, you eat well, you piss well, you sleep well, and you have enthusiasm to work, and you don't hate nobody, you are healthy. So in the morning you get up and say, do I want to go to the department today? If the answer is yes, you are healthy. Then in the review, see, do I have to do help others in the department? If the answer is yes, you are terribly healthy. That is very interesting. Okay, I'll come back. Human metagenome. NIH has been working on metagenome for the last 10 years without telling anybody. They didn't tell our geneticists here. They quietly worked because they said, we will get the metagenome first and teach all these slaves, we make money and teach them. But unfortunately, they found $100 million, 10 years of work, the whole of NIH, which is called the palace, they got only 10 genes. So they said, no. If the whole world's laboratories work on genetics only, 24 hours of the day, for the next 100 years, we will probably not be able to unravel the metagenome because 3 trillion, not 1 or million or billion, genes are there in your gene. So for every 1 cell in your body, 9 cells are germs. So germs are us. Toys are us, you have seen the shop. Germs are us. And you see, you read my article in the BMJ, germs are us. Now we are germs. So you can't be proud. I am so and so. No. You can't even lift its finger without the permission of the E. coli or somebody. And the latest treatment for dying patients with infections, no antibiotic cures. Do you know the latest treatment? Good human feces. Healthy human feces. 250 cc, emulsified, put in a rilestube in, 4 hours later the patient will go home. Americans call it as fecal transplant. So you accept it. Oh, yes, yes, fecal transplant. I'm accepting it. If I told you, now I was watching your faces, you're making some grimacing face. Like that. When I said fecal transplant, everybody is bright. Because Johns Hopkins, it comes from Johns Hopkins. Barbara Starfield has done that and saved a lot of patients with difficile infection, Clostridium difficile. A silly germ kills people in the intensive care unit. So now it has become an accepted fact. Murarji Desai drinks urine, he says, ah. But when it comes from the West, auto urine therapy is very good because it improves your immune system. You read that paper in the PubMed and say, that's right. See? Cow's urine? Like that. Cow's colostrum has come as immune suppressed drug, and one tablet is $10. So you say, it's good. It's very good because it's come from America. Our slavish mentality is you want an American stamp for everything. Or a British stamp. Anything Indian? She. I want the physiology department in every college to buy this book. Every department. This is called Body Electric. This man must be venerated. He must be given not one Nobel Prize, but two. But he was demonized. This man showed that every human cell is a semiconductor. And he showed that energy, electric energy, can cure things like even cancer. His name is Robert Becker. Bob, or Robert Becker, was the professor of orthopedics in the New York State University in the 1950s. For 20 years, he did so much research, but he was demonized. His professorship was removed. They were about to take his degree out, like that Wakeley fellow, and then they were thrown on the road, but he survived. He is no more. May his soul rest in peace. But this book, every physiologist must read, The Electromagnetism and the Foundation of Life.